in continuation of our discussion of organic ions and the fact that organic ions exhibit resonance, this time we take examples of alpha carbon ions, basically carbon ions that are produced as a result of proton abstraction at the alpha position in carbonyl compounds. Let's take beta keto esters. So this is an example of a beta keto ester. And if you look at this beta keto ester, it's actually acidic at two positions, if you like, this position and that position, flanked by the two carbonyl groups. The pK of this position is about 20, which is typical of a normal alpha position or alpha hydrogen in a carbonyl compound. But the pKa of this position, which is flanked by the two carbonyl groups, is actually much less, indicative of the greater relative acidity of that position to that position. So let's write that down. The pKa here at this position is about 20. The pKa here is about 9. But why is that? Well, in order to understand this relative acidity, we need to draw the relative conjugate bases, if you like, or alpha carbonyl. If we take a proton from this alpha position by a suitable base, so we get something like that. So that's the alpha carbonyl, if you like, the conjugate base at that position of the beta keto ester. Now this alpha carbonyl, and remember these positions are called alpha. This is actually alpha, that's alpha, and that's also alpha. But that alpha is very special because it's flanked again by two carbonyl groups. Now this alpha carbonyl is also stabilized by resonance. We use again Kelly arrows to indicate electron movement. So we use this arrow, which originates from the location of that lone pair, and it's going to the middle of that CC single bond. But again, simultaneously, we have to break the carbon oxygen double bond, indicating breakage of the CO pi bond, releasing electrons to oxygen. So something like that is possible. It's resonant, so we need to connect this with the next structure with that arrow, and to draw the lower structure, we have to get something like that. So that's a Lewis structure for this alpha carbonyl. So this is alpha carbonyl. If you look at the second Lewis structure, it actually has a double bond reminiscent of alkenes, if you like, and therefore the ending of ene. If you look at that oxygen, it's like an alkoxide. So therefore, it's like the alkoxide of alcohols. So therefore, it should begin with ATE because it's negatively charged. This intermediate, actually, in organic chemistry, is called enolates. Enolates, so ene because it has a carbon-carbon double bond, olate because it's the conjugate base of an alcohol, something like that. So this is an enolate. So alpha carbonyls, therefore, resonate, if you like, to enolates. They are Lewis structures, which are stabilized in this case by resonance, and that's exactly why carbonyl compounds at that position, at the alpha position, are acidic. Now, what about that position, the other alpha position, which is flanked by the two carbonyl groups? We've said already that the pKa is 9, which is significantly less than 20. So if you compare them, there's a huge difference in magnitude. You're talking about pKa units here. So there must be an additional resonance stabilization, which is the reason behind the relative acidity of that position to the other, or the normal alpha position. To do that, we need to draw the corresponding conjugate base. So we need to remove, if you like, a proton from that position flanked by the two carbonyl groups. And if we do that, we get something like this. So that's the carbonyl, which is produced, if you like, or obtained when one of these acidic hydrogens is removed by a suitable base based on BKs, that's another discussion. Now this alpha carbanion is stabilized by resonance two. So we can draw another resonance structure. We need to indicate electron movement using Kelly arrows just like before. So that's exactly what we do. So this arrow indicates movement of two electrons from this position to that position, the CC single bond. So now we are about to make a double bond. And as a result, this carbon oxygen double bond must simultaneously break because carbon can only be surrounded by 8 and 8 electrons only according to the octet rule. So we have to break, therefore, that carbon oxygen double bond. If we do that, we get another resonance structure. So something like that. So that's another Lewis structure for this alpha carbanion, but that's not yet the full story. Now that this enolate, which is also an enolate, by the way, because it is just like what we have seen before. Now this enolate can undergo further resonance and therefore further resonance stabilization. Therefore, we can draw another resonance structure for this, and that's by movement of one of these lone pairs on oxygen, making a double bond here. At the same time, we need to break that carbon-carbon double bond, and now we make another double bond here. And at the same time, simultaneously, we have to break that carbon oxygen double bond. So you can see this beautiful, this intriguing electron movement, this intriguing resonance stabilization of this enolate, of this beta keto ester enolate at the position which is flanked by the two carbonyl groups. If you do that, we get a third resonance structure. So something like that. Which suggests that this alpha carbanion, the carbanion which is produced when one of these hydrogens flanked at the methylene position, flanked by the two carbonyl groups, is removed. So that alpha carbanion is stabilized by two resonance structures. So this great resonance stabilization is the reason actually behind the relative greater acidity of that methylene group flanked by the two carbonyl groups relative to the normal alpha position.